Ladies and gentlemen,
in these streets I'm walking on air. In these streets I don't have a care. It's sweet, sweet.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by, hello boo. So today's video, I will take you all through my first time trying out the famous Knotless Box Braids. I mean, what other better time to try this hairstyle than now that the sun outside is just beginning to shine? So if you want to see how we achieve this hairstyle, then please keep on watching. And without further ado, let's get started. So starting off with freshly washed hair, I just took my hair right now to pat out the back of this hair just so I could take you all through the back. I know you always like when I show you guys the back of this hair process, even though sometimes, actually not even sometimes, most times the back always turns out to be very somehow, but yeah. Y'all, I also got a fresh hair trim. That video will be coming up very soon, let me not spoil it for you guys. But anyway, so I'm going to go ahead right now to part out the back, and then I use my Shine and Jam gel. That also helps me to be able to align my parting. Once I just place that right there on my hair and on my scalp, it's just a lot easier to smoothen this parting to make sure that my hair is parted at least straight enough that it looks like I put in the good effort. Alright, and the hair we're using in this video is from Darling USA. This is the pre-stretched braiding hair in color 1B. Y'all, this is literally 52 inches. As in 52 inches. Did you hear me? And I love the fact that this already comes pre-stretched, so I don't really have to do that much work. And this is also the 3x pack, so you don't even need that much hair. And y'all, in fact, let me just keep going. Alright, bringing out the strands of hair that we're going to need for this entire knotless braid, I grabbed four chunks of this hair, arranged it from the smallest to the largest, because knotless braids are basically feeding braids, but like individual feeding braids, if that makes sense. So after applying some gel to our hair, I just went ahead right now to part my natural into 3 parts. Start off like you're just doing your regular 3-stranded plaits. Do your 3-stranded plaits up until about two steps all the way, and make sure that the root of your natural hair is properly secure. Especially if your hair is natural, like if you have natural hair, it's so easy for our natural hair to get quite frizzy in this type of hairstyle. So you want to make sure that you're gripping the roots as, in fact, your best gripping game right now, turn it on. So once we've secured the roots of our natural hair right there with the 3-stranded plaits all the way to 2 steps, we're going to grab this extension and attach it right there in the middle. Right there, our index finger. There you go. And then just go ahead to braid. However, make sure that you're only attaching one side of this extension. And then you do 1-step plait again. And then you go ahead to attach the other side of this extension. We're going to do this again, okay? Grab your extension, place it right there in the middle. One side, just the left side of this extension. Leave one side out. Do a single, there you go, like a single 3-stranded plaits, then grab that extension right there and then put it under right there in the same index finger and just keep on braiding. We're going to do this one more time just so we can make sure we're carrying everyone along. So once our index finger is open right there, we're going to grab this extension right there, place it in the middle, and then just go ahead to do like a single 3-stranded plaits, okay? You attach this and keep on going like you're doing your regular braids. And then we'll now grab the other end of this extension that we kept right there on the right sitting and place it right back under the same index finger once it's open again for us to keep braiding. Okay, so repeating this again, we're going to grab this extension, place it right there in the index finger in the middle. Okay, keep on braiding with the rest of our hair. Do a single step braid, just 1 step right there, okay? There you go, you braid, and then once your index finger is open again, we'll just grab the other side of this extension that we kept right there on the right, and then put it back there onto our index finger, and then keep on braiding, okay? And this was basically how we achieved this entire knotless braid. Y'all, this beginning part, it was actually a struggle because this is my first time ever trying this hairstyle. I was like, wow, this is actually way difficult than it actually looks. I literally struggled. But I think as I kept on going, it got a lot better. So you all will see that the improvements in the braids, it just kept on looking better and better. All right? So if you don't give up. Let's try this again. One more time. So after that first one that we had right there at the back, I split the extension that we're going to be using into 5 strands instead of 4. because I felt like it would add seamlessly and the feeding would just be seamless. I felt like the previous one, the very first one we did, was a little bit too bulky at some point. So I just evened out this extension onto 5 strands moving forward. Okay, so splitting our natural hair right there into three equal parts, we're going to go away right now to do our regular 3-stranded braids. Okay, so we'll start with just our natural hair, no extension. That's what makes it knotless. So it's like no extension at the roots and it just feels flat and lightweight. So we'll do 2 steps of this. Once we have our index finger open right there exactly, we're going to grab the smallest of this extension, attach it right there, okay, just one side of it, in this case the left side, and then we'll go ahead right now to braid, just regular braids, one step of that. Once your index finger is open again, then you attach the other side of this extension onto the same index finger and then keep on braiding. Keep on doing the same thing, grabbing this extension, attaching it right there onto our index finger, and then braid, one step, boom, boom, and then grab this other side, place it right under, and then continue braiding. So this is basically how you do your feed-in braids, but the only difference is that this is individual feed-in braids, okay? Yo, I hope this is making sense. I made sure I did this entire hairstyle on different angles of our hair just so we can make sure we're carrying everyone along. So I did on the sides, the middle, the back, just so, you know, everyone is following and it's just easy for us to pull through this hairstyle together, all right? Okay. I'm just going to allow you guys to keep on watching right now. In these streets I'm walking on air. In these streets I don't have a care. It's sweet, sweet, the wind's in my hair. Nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Beep, beep, the neighbors say hi. I'm gonna bake them a pie and sit on the porch till it's night. Nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Not every day is like this, so I'ma soak up what I got. While it is the newspaper, I'll read later. Right now I'm feeling so good. I'm feeling so good in my neighborhood. Feeling so good, so good, so good. I'm feeling so good in my neighborhood. Feeling so good, so good, so good. Yo, one thing I enjoy so much about this knotless braids is literally how flat they are. Like, I had an entire head of braids, but it doesn't feel like I have an entire head of braids. Like, how? Yo, this hairstyle actually feels good. It's just a perfect summer vacation type of vibe. It's giving everything. It's giving, hello, baby girl, what's popping? Going through this entire process again, now that we're in this middle front section of our hair, we're just going to go through this again. So I grabbed this extension that we're going to be using right now, split this across 5 strands of this extension, going from the smallest to the biggest, because we're going to start from the smallest, and when we're adding the extension, we are going from the smallest one all the way upwards to the biggest one. The thing is, the longer and the more extension you add, of course your hair is going to be a lot longer. So if you want yours to be longer and going longer, you can add as much extension as you want, but I felt like 5 was just perfect for the length and for the size that I was going for. So splitting our natural right there into 3 equal parts, we're going to go ahead right now to start doing our regular 3-stranded braid. Cross our hair over the other, just the regular, you know, the regular degola. Once we have the roots of our natural hair secure in this 3-stranded braid all the way to 2 steps of that, we're going to go ahead right now to have our index finger right there in the middle open, attach this extension onto the middle, okay, do your regular braid, and then once you have one step of that braid and you have your index finger open again, we're going to grab the other side of this extension and then keep on braiding, okay? So grabbing the extension that you have, attach it right there in the middle, do a whole 3-stranded plait, just like so, and then once you have your index finger open again, you grab the other side of this extension and then you keep on braiding. Okay, so grabbing this extension right there in the middle, attaching it, okay, attaching it right there onto your index finger. Once it's open again, you grab the other end. You see how that's going smoothly? You see? So you just keep on going until you've added all the 5 strands of this extension. And voila, come on. No one is going to be able to talk to you anyhow after you're done with this hairstyle, I'm telling you. And then one quick tip to make this hairstyle a lot faster and a lot easier as you're going is, once you grab your extension that you're going to be using for each braid, each knotless braid, make sure that you arrange them into like the 5 or whatever number of strands of hair that you're going to be feeding in. Arrange them on the side, lay it down on a table or on the floor, wherever you're working. In that way, it's just a lot easier to grab. That's going to make the process faster, easier, and even a lot more smoother. Okay, if that's not an English word, but you get the point. Jump back if you're trying to come sideways. I don't need your bad vibes today. But if you want to change your tone, you can play. But nothing can make me feel. Once we're done filling in all of that extension, going forward, you want to make sure that you're tapping, like touching your gel, your braiding gel that you're using while braiding, just so you can make sure that your natural hair is also staying, laying down, everything is staying secure. Just give it a little touch on the body and then keep on braiding with some gel on your hands. This just helps make sure that your natural hair is staying laid as you're doing your entire braiding process. I also wanted to give you all an up-close view of this entire braiding process and also how you borrow extension. You know when one side of your extension is thinning out and the other one has more hair? Exactly. So just basically borrow it effortlessly, just so it doesn't look like you borrowed. Borrow it effortlessly and then just keep on braiding to the very end. Normally when I get to the very end of my braids, I just, you know, twist the ends. You know when the hair is basically just finishing at the very end? So I just twist it right there and your braids are properly secure. So starting off with this new strand of hair that we're going to be working on right now. So I grabbed my Shine and Jam gel. You all know how much I love the Shine and Jam gel. I normally prefer to stick to, you know, jams, something that's very good for braiding. I love the fact that this doesn't flake. It literally just melts into your hair. So it melts into your braid. So it doesn't flake at all. I know right now it looks a little, you know, a little whitish and all of that stuff. But yo, this dissolves. It's literally jam. It just dissolves like bread and butter. So it's so easy to use for braiding. It's always my go-to gel. Of course, you could use any braiding gel you have available to you, but you want to make sure that you're sticking to a braiding gel, okay? You don't want anything that's going to be giving you flaky or any of those. You want something that's going to be like a jam that will just feel moisturizing while still giving your natural hair a little bit of a hold for you to go on with your entire braiding process. For this entire head of hair, y'all, we ended up using 2.5 packs of this Darling USA extension. This is 100% Kanekalon hair, so we ended up using 2.5 packs. This is why I always love the 3x. So the 3x bulky packs of extension, I feel like they are way more economical because sometimes you just need only 1 pack, maximum 2 packs sometimes, and you're good to go. But because these braids are long, like long, it's also jumbo in terms of its size. We ended up using 2.5 packs of hair. Yo, this hair goes all the way. When I tell you my bonbon was feeling this hair, my bonbon was just in wham, wham. This hair is long. I love it. I feel like it's just perfect for this summer. And another thing I love about this knotless braids, I don't know if I mentioned this already, but y'all, it feels so comfortable. I know I have braids on my head, but it doesn't feel like I have braids. It feels lightweight. It feels flat. Like my scalp feels like, whoa, all the breeze is just blowing from north, south, and east. I just love that. This entire hairstyle took quite a while. This hairstyle ended up taking almost 6.5 hours. This hairstyle literally took 6 hours. I feel like it's because it was also my first time. I've never done any hairstyle like this knotless braid before. So I was kind of having some struggles, especially at the beginning, at the back. And because it's also long, so that also contributed to the amount of time it took. But yeah, I definitely enjoyed it. I'm so happy I ended up trying this hairstyle because I'm just like, why did I try this a long time ago? This is so flawless. I also forgot to mention that I ended up using the exact same length of hair for the entire head of hair. I did not cut this extension while braiding, so everything is the exact same length. Okay, I'll just let you all to keep on watching, just so you know, you can keep on following what's going on. Yeah, yeah. Nah, 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 nah. Yeah. It's body, baby, oh. Body, baby, oh. Nah, 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 yeah. It's your
happy day. It's a wedding day. Make we celebrate. Make we celebrate. To make you dance, dance. And make you move, move. Make you dance, dance. And make you move, move. Iba die lulu, ganga o. Iba die lulu, jeje. Iba die lulu, ganga o. So I go give you daughter, she go call you mommy, and she go call me daddy, and we go call her baby, oh. Oh, I tell her so, hey, show my family love, hey, oh, hey, oh. Let me be your man tonight, tonight, and I just wanna be the one you like, only go far by the gojo. Say I want you to be mine, money go far by the gojo. Say I want you to be mine. Oh. It's your happy day, it's your wedding day. Make we celebrate, oh. Make we celebrate, oh. To make you dance, dance, and make you move, move. Make you dance, dance, and make you move, move. Iba die lulu, ganga o. Iba die lulu, jeje. Iba die lulu. Long ago, Ibadi Elulu, Jeje. Baby oh, baby oh, baby oh, I just want you to be my lady. Yeah. What God has joined together.
So now that we're basically done with this entire hairstyle, this is basically it. A girl is looking like every form of chocolate right now that exists. Come on, hello. So I just went ahead right now to trim the body of this extension. I just trimmed all the excess flyaways on this hair. This is just to make sure that my hair is staying neat. I also ended up with 40 strands of these braids. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to soak this hair in hot water. This is going to help to seal the ends of this braid. It's also going to give your braids that slick look, that slick finish. Everything is going to be looking straight and nice. And then I trimmed the ends. I just did that quick, you know. That's, I don't really know what to call that cut, but you all know that hair, that shabby shabby kind of cut right there at the end, just so the hair is all level to the length I wanted it to be. And then I went ahead right now to also touch this hot water on the body of this hair. Hot water on the body of this hair also helps to reduce tension on your scalp and anything or anything like that. And it also helps to reduce all the flyaways. And then I oiled my scalp. And then right now I'm using this African Pride Foaming Mousse. Y'all, this mousse smells like God sent. Like, this is just going to help to lay down all of that flyaways to make sure that our hair is neat, nice, and our braids are just looking very smooth. And I also like the moisturizing effect that this hair mousse adds to the braids. And y'all, this is the following morning. I just went ahead to do just a little bit of edges here and there. And then tie down my satin head wrap. And come on, hey, 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 case have closed. As per Uka Abasa, case have dismissed. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Better than your favorite bad bitch. Turn the whole world into a sad bitch. Middle finger and all of my...
I went ahead to, of course, accessorize this hair. You all know now. You all know. And this is basically the end of this hairstyle, y'all. A girl is looking like, wow, morning sunlight. The sunshine is really sprinkling on this woman here right now. Well, y'all, let me know down in the comment section if you tried out the one and only Knotless braid. Thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. Comment, share, subscribe. And I'll see you all in my next one. Have a lovely rest of your weekend. Love you lots. Bye!